السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. My brothers and respected elders, all praises for Allah who's gathered us here with His favor and mercy. We haven't just come, Allah's brought us here. Allah gives tawfiq for everything. وَمَا تَوْفِيقِي إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Allah gives tawfiq for whatever people do. وَمَا كَانَ لِنَفْسٍ أَن تُؤْمِنَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. No one can be a Muslim and a believer without Allah's will. Allah allows people to believe. And if Allah so wanted, لَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَآمَنَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ كُلُّهُمْ جَمِيعًا. If Allah had so wanted, Allah could have given hidayat and iman to all the people of the world. وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ لَجْعَلَكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدًا. If Allah had so wanted, Allah could have made all the people into one nation. But Allah has decided, Allah created humanity and mankind. فَوَالَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ فَمِنْكُمْ كَافِرٌ وَمِنْكُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ. He created us all and decided some will be blessed with iman and some will not be blessed with iman. Those who are blessed with iman, they are called mu'min. Those who have been deprived have been termed by Allah as kafirs, as the deprived ones. So Allah is the one who gives hidayat. Allah is the one who guides. But we all need to seek hidayat from Allah. We are all in need of hidayat. We are all beggars in front of Allah. Ya ayyuhan nas, antumul fuqara'u ila Allah. All you people, all you Asians, you Africans, you Europeans, you Americans, wherever people live, all people, whether they be human, whether they be animals, whether angels, whether jinns, everybody is in need of Allah, and Allah is in need of no one. أقول هو الله أحد الله السمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Allah is the absolutely unique one. ليس كمثله شيء. There is nothing like Allah. He is the one and only one of His kind. He doesn't have a mother. He doesn't have a father. He doesn't depend upon anything. There is absolutely nothing like Allah. And we are dependent upon Allah in all our affairs. And there is a wonderful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All hadiths of the Prophet are wonderful. But in this particular hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned on behalf of Allah. And such a hadith is known as Hadith al-Qudsi, in which Allah says, Ya ibadi, kullukum dallun illa man hadaytuhu. Oh you people, you are all off the path. You don't know what is hidayat. Now you don't know. You don't know what you are doing. كُلُّكُمْ ضَالٌ إِلَّا مَنْ هَدَيْتُهُ. Except whom I guide. فَاسْتَهْدُونِي أَهْدِكُمْ. Ask me to guide you, I will guide you. Because when Allah guides anyone, if Allah puts the nur of Islam and Iman in the hearts of people, then who can take it away? مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهُ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلْهُ فَلَا هَادِيَ لَهُ. You must have heard all khatibs recite these verses of the Quran every Friday. Every Friday, most khatibs recite this in their Juma Khutbah even. And whenever a khatib, he begins his address or his speech or a lecture, most khatibs, they recite this as well. And so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to recite it. If Allah guides anyone, then no one can mislead them. And if Allah misguides anyone, then who can show them hidayah? After someone has been deprived by Allah, who dares to bless them and who can bless them? So Allah says, ask me, I will guide you. So we have been commanded by Allah to seek hidayat. Hidayat is our ultimate need. If Allah was to show us the right path and to guide us, the straight path, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Oh Allah, show us the straight path, the path of those upon whom you showered your favors. صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. And not the path of those with whom Allah was angry, and neither the path of those who were led astray. May Allah save us from the fact that Allah be ever angry with us. Allah is arhamur rahimin, and ever since Allah created makhluq, Allah has written in front of Himself on the arsh, إِنَّ رَحْمَتِي سَبَقَتْ عَلَى غَضَبِي. That His rahmat will always be dominant over His anger. So Allah does get angry. It's not that Allah doesn't get angry. Allah does get angry. And when Allah gets angry, Allahu Akbar, then Allah save us. And then even the heavens and the earth and the mountains, they shake. Because when Allah is angry, Allahu Akbar. We don't know. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith, he said, إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ وَأَسْمَعُ مَا لَا تَسْمَعُونَ. I see what you don't see, and I hear what you don't hear. لو تعلمون ما أعلم, and if you were to know what I know, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لَضَحِكْتُمْ قَلِيلًا وَلَضَكَيْتُمْ كَثِيرًا. You would laugh very little and you would cry a lot. Because we simply just don't know. We are ignorant. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Allah describes humans in the Quran as zalims and jahils. They don't know. They just don't know how, who they are. They don't know what's required of them. They don't know who's created them. They don't recognize their Lord as their Lord. Allah ought to be recognized. And Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِ. Oh, you people, you don't value me as I ought to be valued. If you have a boss and your boss calls you, then you have no hesitation. You'll respond immediately, whether it be midnight, whether it be early in the morning, whether it be late at night, because you regard him as your boss. And he is the ultimate boss. أحكم الحاكمين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين. Is Allah not the ultimate ruler of all rulers? So we don't recognize Allah as Allah ought to be recognized. Hence Allah introduces him. Allah talks about himself. Allah is proud of himself. One of Allah's names, Al-Mutakabbir. Al-Mutakabbir means the proud one. Because Allah has got plenty to be proud about. Because he's the all-knowing, he's the all-seeing. As-Sami, Al-Basir. Allah is the all-seeing, Allah is the all-hearing, Allah is the all-doing. إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. Whenever he wants to do something, he doesn't need to plan. He doesn't need assistance. He doesn't need any planning permission. He doesn't need any approvals. He doesn't need any appreciation. Allah simply says, be, and it's done. كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. وَاللَّهُ غَالِبٌ عَلَى أَمْرِهِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Allah is totally dominant over all his affairs, but most people just simply don't know. Most people simply just don't understand. And most people just don't even want to know. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. They don't know and they don't want to know. Insan is azeem makhluq of Allah. So Allah sent many a prophets. And Allah said in Surah Yasin, which is the heart of Quran, and Muslims are encouraged to recite it regularly. On daily basis, if you recite Surah Yasin in the morning, and then Allah will look after all your affairs of the day. It's the heart of Quran. And just as heart is the main organ in your body, Surah Yasin is the central surah with the central theme and the central message. Allah addresses people. Ya hasratana ala al-ibad. Allah says, oh, woe you people, woe be unto you. Woe be unto you. Ma yatihim min rasulin illa kanu bihi. Yes, تَعْزِرُونَ. Because Allah is merciful. Allah has created us. Allah knows us. Allah knows us better than what we can ever know ourselves. We don't know what's good for us. We don't know what's harmful for us. Allah knows better and Allah knows best. And this is what Allah says in the Quran. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah knows. Listen to Allah. Allah knows. You don't know. You don't know what's going to happen in the next moment. Let alone tomorrow and next week and next month and next year. As the poet has said, aga apni maut se koi bashar nahi, sama so baras ka pal ki khabar nahi. People plan, they make plans for 100 years ahead, but they can't guarantee one moment, they can't guarantee one breath. So Allah says, you don't know, I know, Allah says. Allah knows the future and the past and the present. Allah knows the state and condition of every person, every human, every woman, every man, every child, every jinn, every angel. Where every animal, every fish, every bird, wherever there is anything, it's all in the knowledge and the qudrat of Allah. Allah knows. مَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا. Whenever any leaf falls from any tree, wherever a single drop of rain falls, it's all in the knowledge of Allah. Allah gives the order and permission, hence it falls. It falls with the will of Allah. Every child who comes to this world does so because Allah sends him. And no one can leave this world. وَمَا كَانَ لِنَفْسٍ أَن تَمُوتَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. And it might surprise you. Allah has mentioned this. وَمَا كَانَ لِنَفْسٍ أَن تَمُوتَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. No soul can even die without Allah causing him to die. And Allah has mentioned this after mentioning about Rasulullah. In the two ayats previously, Allah says, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ. And my beloved Prophet Muhammad is the Rasul. Just as many Rasuls came before him, then Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ لِنَفْسٍ أَن تَمُوتَ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. No soul can even die without permission from Allah. Allah gives permission for the sun to rise and the sun to set, the seasons to change, and the weathers to change, for the rain to come, for the sun to shine. Whatever happens, happens with the will of Allah. So Allah says, you don't know. I know, Allah says, so listen to Allah. Oh, listen to Allah. Whatever Allah says, that is right, that is haq. That is good for us. Otherwise, if we just leave it to ourselves, there will be many a times, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. There will be many things that you don't like, but they are good for you. وَعَسَىٰ أَن تُحِبُّوا شَيْئًا وَهُوَ شَرٌّ لَكُمْ. There will be many things that you like and you want, and you are so desperate to have them, but they are not good for you. They will ruin you, they will destroy you. And I'm sure many people must have experienced. Sometimes they want something desperately and they pray for it as well, but it doesn't materialize. It doesn't happen. Then many years or months down the line, you say, Alhamdulillah, thank God I didn't get that. And sometimes people think it's not good. Shaitan makes people afraid. الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. Shaitan, he shows many things. He makes you afraid. And he thinks, how will you survive? How will you eat? What will you do? But Allah says, وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِّنُ وَفَضْلًا. Allah wants to promise you His fazl and His forgiveness. If you listen to Allah, Allah will tell you what's really good for you. Allah will tell you what's right for you. Allah wants to lead you. لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِّنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. Allah وَلِيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Allah is your friend. And we think people are our friends, but they just want fun at our expense. And most people are just acquaintances. And people don't really have true friends. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if I was to make a friend, I would take Abu Bakr to be my friend. But my friend is Allah. Abu Bakr was worthy of being a good friend. The Prophet said, Al-mar'u ala deeni khalilihi. A man is on the deen of his friends. فَلْيَنْظُرْ أَحَدُكُمْ مَنْ يُخَالِلْ. So be careful whom you befriend. Don't make anybody to be your friend. I'm not saying regard other people and everybody as your enemies. No. But be careful whom you trust, with whom you, mashallah, associate, who you give your heart to, who you confide in. True friends are very rare to come by. So be careful whom you befriend. Allah is our real friend. And one of Allah's names is Wali. Wali means a friend. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Khatamun Nabiyyin. From the people, the most chosen are the prophets. But Allah hasn't named himself as a Nabi. Because the Nubuwwah was going to come to an end upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So all of Allah's attributes are absolute and perfect and personal. Allah's knowledge has been since the beginning and will always be. Similarly, Allah's qudrat, Allah's authority. Similarly, Allah's friendship. One of Allah's name, Al-Wali. The friend. Allah is the friend of all believers. Allah didn't call himself Nabi. Allah didn't call himself Nabi. Although Allah has all the knowledge, but Allah didn't call himself Nabi because Nabuwwah was going to come to an end. But Allah has called himself Wali, a friend. And he is a friend of all true believers. Allahu waliyyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. Allah is your friend. If you believe sincerely and truly and completely in Allah and you trust him, if you were to trust upon Allah as Allah ought to be trusted, then Allah will look after you and provide for your needs as Allah does for the birds. In the morning, they leave their nests empty stomach, hungry. Hungry and thirsty, they leave. And when they return in the evening, they come satisfied. They return to their nests all content and eaten fully and satisfied. There's no restaurants for birds. They don't have any breakfast in their nests before they fly out. They don't take any packed lunch. MashaAllah, this man, Ashraful Makhluqat, the human, as soon as he gets up, he wants a breakfast. Then he tells his wife to prepare a packed lunch. Then when he goes, mashallah, he has lunch time and coffee time and then tea time. And then when he comes home hungry. The birds leave their nests without any breakfast. There's no packed lunch, there's no restaurant, no cafe where they go. They leave in the trust of Allah. And when they come home at night to their nests, they return. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when they leave hungry. When they return all satisfied. And if you were to trust in Allah as Allah ought to be trusted, Allah will provide for your needs similarly as well. If Allah can provide for birds, if Allah can provide for animals, if Allah provides for those who don't even believe, then what do you think? Allah will let his friends down? Allah will never let his friends down. Allah is truthful in his promise. Ya ayyuhanna, inna wa'ad Allahi haq. O you people, the promise of Allah is haq. Allah's name, one of Allah's names, Allah has 99 names. And in another hadith, there are so many names of Allah that only Allah knows. So when you talk to Allah, when you make dua to Allah, and dua is such a blessing of Allah for this ummah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, ad-dua'u huwa al-ibadah. Dua is true worship. Ad-dua'u mukhu al-ibadah. It's the gist of all ibadah. Hence, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us many duas. In the Quran, there are many duas. The Quran begins with a dua and ends with a dua. And Surah Fatiha, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, Ahdina Sirat al-Mustaqeem. And then, Qul A'udhu bi Rabbil Falaq, Qul A'udhu bi Rabbil Nas. You seek Allah's refuge from Allah's anger. I was saying that Allah does become angry as well. Allah does become angry as well. When people disobey Allah, then Allah becomes angry. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his du'as used to seek Allah's refuge from Allah's anger. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika. Allahumma inni a'udhu bi ridaka min sakhatika. Ya Allah, I seek refuge in your happiness from your anger. Ya Allah. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika minka. Ya Allah, I seek your refuge from you. If you become angry, then where can I run? Then where can we go? Where can we hide? There's no place in the heavens nor in the earth. Until the deepest cave or in the deeper and under the deepest of the oceans, you can't hide from Allah. Once a Sahabi was making dua, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sitting nearby, and Sahabi, when he finished his salat, he made a dua. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat by listening to what he was saying and how he was making dua. And the Sahabi raised his hand and said, Ya Allah, Ya man la tarahu al-uyur, O he who can't be seen with the eyes, wa la tukhalituhu al-dhunur, and he who can't be imagined in the wildest imagination by any mind, wa la yasifuhu al-wasifun, and no one describing you can describe you, wa la tughayyiruhu al-hawadith, wa la yakhsha al-dawa'ir. He who doesn't fear any revolution or any change. There are many revolutions in many parts of the world, in many ages. People do all sorts of things and all sorts of things happen. But no one can rebel against Allah. If all the makhluk, Ya Ibadi, in that hadith I recited earlier, Allah says, Ya Ibadi, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا ولا أفجر قلب رجل منكم. All you people, if all your humans and all your jinns and all the ones who ever been, all the ones who ever will be, if you all became like the worst person amongst you and you rebelled against Allah, it doesn't do Allah any harm. It doesn't do Allah. مَا يَنْقُصْ ذَلِكَ مِمَّا عِنْدِي شَيْئًا وَيَا عِبَادِي لَوْ أَنَّ أَوَّلَكُمْ وَآخِرَكُمْ وَإِنْسَكُمْ وَجِنَّكُمْ كَانُوا وَلَا أَتْقَى قَلْبِ رَجُلٍ مِّنْكُمْ. If all you people, all your men and your women, the ones who have ever been, the ones who ever will be, all the humans and the jinns, if you all became like the best person amongst you, مَا زَادَ فِي مُلْكِ شَيْئًا. Allah says, it won't do me any good. I am still Allah. Allah is Allah. Whether people believe or disbelieve or obey or disobey or submit or rebel, Allah is Allah. No one can do Allah any harm. But if Allah becomes angry, Allah forbid. So The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his du'as has taught us to seek refuge in Allah and to ask Allah. وَإِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. When you have a problem, turn to Allah. Ask Allah. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Ya Allah, we alone we worship and thee alone we ask for help. And to ask Allah. إِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهِ. وَإِذَا سَأَلْتَ فَاسْتَعِنْ بِاللَّهِ. And be aware. وَعَلَمَ أَنَّ أُمَّكَ لَوِ اجْتَمَعَتْ عَلَىٰ أَن يَنْفَعُوكَ بِشَيْءٍ لَمْ يَنْفَعُوكَ إِلَّا بِشَيْءٍ قَدْ كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكَ. If all the people got together and they want to give you something, and Allah doesn't want to give you, then nobody can give you anything. وَعَلَمْ. And be aware that if all the people get together and they want to harm you, they can't do you any harm except what Allah has written. And so Allah, so don't run away from Allah. فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. Allah says, run towards Allah. Don't run away from Allah. Where can you run? If you ran, you started running, you might be the fastest man in the world. You might have the fastest rocket in the world. And Allah says, run. If you want to run and fly, fly. Ya ma'ashar al-jinni wal-insi nistata'tu man tanfudhu min aqtari samawati wal-ardi fanfudhu. All you humans and all you jinns, if you think you can run away from Allah, you think you can get away and escape, then try, run, run. How will you run? Where will you run to? أينما تكونوا يدرككم الموت ولو كنتم في بروج مشيدة. If you build yourselves castles to save yourselves, wherever Even then, when Allah sends His messenger, when Allah sends the angel to pick you up, he won't do it. When we were coming to Marcus, one of the brothers was saying, and they went in the gush, and they went in the marketplace, and the brother would listen. So one of the brothers said, "Brother, sit down, listen to me." He goes, I'm too busy even to die. And he goes, "Brother, you can turn us away, but when the angel of death comes, he's not going to knock on the door. He's not going to say, 'Brother, I see you very busy. Here, take my card, my mobile number. Give me a ring whenever you're ready.'" No one has ever to this day been able to turn him away. Your best friend might come and knock for you, and you might say, "Brother, not today. I've got a very serious program. I've promised my father, my mother, my son, my daughter, my wife, whosoever." And you can turn your friends away. You can even say no to your parents, although you shouldn't, not to your mother, not to your father. But if you did, it's possible, but no one has ever been born who said no to Malakul Maut. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam tried it. Allah sent Malakul Maut to Musa alayhi salam. And when he came to Musa alayhi salam, he said, "Allah has sent me." And he said, "Subhanallah, you came, well, you come to pick me up?" Musa alayhi salam slapped him one proper one. And he took his eye out. And Malakul Maut went back to Allah, "Ya Allah, you send me to someone, look at what he's done." Allah says, "Don't worry, I'll sort it out." And go and tell Musa, "You see that ox near you? Put your hand on the ox, and as many hair under your hand, I will increase so many years." Yeah. And then he came down, this is what Allah says. And he says, and then he said, "I'll come back again. But if you're going to come back later on, I might as well go with you now." And no one has ever been able to turn him away. And he won't, and we are not going to be the first one, certainly. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Al-kayyisu man dana nafsahu wa amila lima ba'd al-maut." A wise person is he who controls himself. Don't do whatever comes in the heart. Don't say anything you want to say. Don't look at everything you want to see. Don't listen to everything you want to hear. Whatever you want to hear might not be good. But we are Allah's servants. We have to submit ourselves to Allah. Allah has given us eyes and ears and hands and feet and mind. Alam naj'al lahu 'aynayn. Allah says, "Who's given you these eyes? Did I not give you these eyes? So see with the eyes. Fa'tabiru ya ulil absar. Look with the eyes and see with the eyes with the intention of seeking lesson. Look at all the people who used to roam on this earth before you. What are we? There were many a nation. And they used to say, 'Man ashaddu minna quwwa?' Who's stronger than us? And what are we? If somebody is 6'6", I would think, mashallah, you think twice about how you're going to address him. 6'6" or whatever. But the ulama have said their children were born 6'6". And they used to uproot trees with their bare hands. And they said, "Man ashaddu minna quwwa?" Allah says, "Don't get carried away. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّ اللَّهَ الَّذِي خَلَقَهُمْ هُوَ أَشَدُّ مِنْهُمْ قُوَّةً." Don't you see that Allah who created you is much, much superior and stronger? You think you are strong? Allah said to them, let me show you. Then Allah sent some wind. سَخَّرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سَبْعَ لَيَالٍ. 7 nights and 8 days. The wind blew, and with the wind they flew. When the wind blew, they flew. And Allahu Akbar, it would whirl them around and topple them. And then, mashallah, such big men, you can imagine how big their legs were, and how big their arms were, and how big their body was, all cut up into pieces. فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِي. Allah said, "I didn't leave anyone, I didn't spare anyone." And not just them, Allah says, كَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا مِنَ الْقُرُونِ مِنْ بَعْدِ نُوحٍ. How many civilizations, when they got carried away in different ways, Allah just got rid of them. It is the fazl of Allah, the barakah and the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which he made for this ummah, that in spite of all the weaknesses and the wrong that we do, Allah doesn't punish us in the manner that Allah used to punish previous nations. When people did what they did, قوم شعيب, قوم عاد, قوم ثمود, قوم نوح, فمنهم من أغرقنا, many nations Allah drowned, فمنهم من أرسلنا عليه حاسبا, and many other nations Allah dealt with differently. Allah sent wind, and Allah sent angels to scream, and their hearts and livers burst. And all that we do, even in spite of what we are, all that collective wrong perhaps is happening today. The Qawm of Lut alayhi salatu wasalam, when they became how they became and they started doing what they did, then Allah sent Jibreel, and he just took their whole town, and on with the tip of his wing, he picked them up and then toppled them upside down, and then Allah sent a shower of rocks upon them. A shower of rocks upon them. And all these evils are taking place today. But it's the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam which is covering over us. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once made a very long sajda. A very long sajda. And he prayed to Allah. Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, today we noticed something and we saw unusually, extraordinarily long sajda. Ya Rasulullah, what happened? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made three duas to Allah. Ya Allah, let my ummah not starve and suffer in a manner that the entire ummah will be wiped out as previous nations were. And Allah accepted it. Ya Allah, don't impose an enemy against them who will wipe them out totally. Allah accepted that dua as well. Don't impose any drought, hardship upon my ummah which will wipe them out. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prayed, Ya Allah, let my ummah not be divided. Let my ummah not be divided into sects. Let them remain united in one. Allah did not accept that dua. So we see what's happening all around. People, all the wrong that they do, because of the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, disobedience to parents, drinking, gambling, whatever evil you can think about, it's there. It's there. But Allah doesn't punish us like Allah used to punish people before. Yeah. Why? Because Allah, being Rabbul Alameen, sent His beloved Prophet as Rahmatul Lil Alameen. And Allah said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. Allah will not punish them as long as you are amongst them, and Allah will not punish them as long as they continue making istighfar. People in the world, mashallah, making istighfar on behalf of the whole ummah, and they are holding Allah's azab back. They are a mercy and a blessing for this ummah. People amongst them, amongst us, people in this ummah, they are holding back the azab of Allah because they make istighfar. When people go in jamaat, when they go in the path of Allah, mashallah, one of the things people do is make istighfar. They love each other for the sake of Allah. It says in one hadith, when Allah decides to send His azab upon a locality and sees there are three groups of people, Allah holds His azab back. One of them are people who, mashallah, frequent the masajid. And in Tabligh, you go from one masjid to another masjid. This is the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet went in a journey, Subhanallah, yatra bi abdihi laylan min al masjid al haram ila al masjid al aqsa. Allah took His beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from one masjid to another. So when you go in jamaat, you travel from one masjid to another masjid. You frequent the masajid, you spend your day in the masjid, you spend your night in the masjid, you call people to masjid. And then you love each other for the sake of Allah. Those who've been there would know. And when you go for 3 days, when you go for 10 days, total strangers. Although nowadays our elders, they say make jamaat from your masjid, from your mahalla and makhluq jamaat and go. But mashallah, whenever you go in jamaat with anyone, you find in the beginning you are strangers. You don't know each other, but when you go home after 3 days or 10 days, mashallah, Allah induces love in the heart, and you love them like you love your own brothers. Many a times, people don't even love their own brothers like the way they love the brothers who spend time together in the path of Allah. So when you find people who love each other for the sake of Allah, and then people who make istighfar in the later part of the night. Allah loves this so much. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَقْرَبُ مَا يَكُونُ الرَّبُّ مِنَ الْعَبْدِ فِي جَوْفِ اللَّيْلِ الْآخِرِ. The nearest Allah comes to people. One thing is for us to try and be near Allah. And another thing for Allah to come to us. The nearest Allah comes to people, and in other words, gives them the most attention is in the later part of the night. فَإِنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ أَن تَكُونَ مِمَّنْ يَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي تِلْكَ السَّاعَةِ فَكُلْ. If you can try and be amongst the people who remember Allah and make His dhikr and make specially istighfar, وَبِالْأَسْحَارِ هُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. They make istighfar in the later part of the night, then be so. Remember Allah in the later part of the night. This calms and cools Allah's anger. And you will be like a shield protecting people from the azab of Allah. So the work of tabligh is Allah's special blessing. You find people, mashallah, they frequent the masajid and they love each other for the sake of Allah. They make istighfar in the later part of the night. Allah gives tawfiq when you go in the path of Allah. Allah gives you tawfiq because you're in the masjid.
And usually, mashallah, sometimes the local brothers, they come early as well. And if the brothers are asleep, mashallah, we're kind enough to wake them up anyway. And so, mashallah, you get the opportunity to wake up and you make istighfar, you make dua to Allah. So the work of tabligh is holding back Allah's azab from the ummah, general azab from the ummah. Don't look down upon this. Although, Hazrat Ji rahimahullah used to say, Allah has covered the work of tabligh with simplicity. Most people just see tabligh, fadale amal, what's this man? And the same things again, mashallah, same gush, same tarheeb, same hadithes, Allahu Akbar. Mashallah, many people recite Quran, and you always, mashallah, you begin from Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, seen one nas, and then you begin again. Same, mashallah, same. It's the word of Allah, Allamul Ghuyub, who has all the knowledge, all the treasures of knowledge. But yet, his kalam, Allah has confined it, mashallah. Allah has put it into 30 juz or 114 surahs and given it to us. And mashallah, we recite. Many people recite, mashallah, in 3 days or 10 days. Oh, mashallah, 1 week or 1 month, mashallah, they recite Quran. Every year, 10, 15, 20 Quran. Over 40 years, you can imagine how many hundreds of Qurans they've recited. Again, the same thing. And in this time and age, Allah has accepted this book, Fazal-e Amal. Perhaps after the Quran, the most recited book. It's been translated into so many languages. And in any case, almost half of the Ummah in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh. MashaAllah, almost 1 billion Muslims worldwide, and in these 3-4 countries, almost, mashallah, half a billion. Almost half the Ummah. Almost half of the total ummah is in these 3-4 countries, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, China, and in these countries. And mashallah, Fazal-e Amal is read in Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, in English. English is international language now, mashallah. It's been translated into English in Africa, in America, all over the world. This is a sign of qubuliyat from Allah. If it wasn't so, people wouldn't be doing it. People wouldn't be doing it. So mashallah, you hear these things, Fazal of Amal. Some people say, there's zaif hadiths in Fazal-e Amal. But the zaif hadiths about what? About salat, about zikrullah. How many ayats in the Quran about zikrullah? Ibn Kathir rahimahullah has written that there is nothing Allah has ordained and then not set limits upon it. Allah has ordained 5 daily salat. 5. Or ordained us to pray, commanded us to pray salat and set limits. 5 obligatory. Anything else you pray, optional, nothing, voluntary. If you pray, well and good, mashallah, nurun ala nur. But if you don't, Allah will not punish you. Allah has ordained salat 5 times a day, zakat 2.5%, fasting 1 month in a year, hajj, a very, very noble and special amal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-hajj, man hajja lillah walam yarfus walam yasuk rada ka yawmin waladat ummu. A person who performs hajj purely for the sake of Allah, and doesn't do anything indecent, then he returns as though the day he was born. Al-Hajj al-Mabrur laysa lahu jaza'un illa al-Jannah. A properly performed Hajj carries no reward except guaranteed paradise, but only once in your life. Only once in your life. Whatever Allah has ordained, you might be a millionaire or a billionaire, but you only have to pay 2.5% of not your earnings, but your savings. Whatever you have under the mattress, wherever. And you're locked in the wherever. Only 2.5% once a year has left. If you want, you can spend all your money in the path of Allah, like Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala. I know Allah will not question you and punish you, but for us not advisable. Think about your family as well. It's better to leave something for your children than to make them hungry and let them starve and then let them spread your hands. Because our children are not like the children of Abu Bakr. Radiallahu ta'ala. Our wives are not like the wives of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala. He spent so much, everything in the path of Allah. Allah then blessed him in a manner. Allah didn't bless any other Sahabi. He is the only Sahabi whose both parents were Muslims and Sahaba. His mother Umm Jamil radiallahu ta'ala became a Muslim before Hijrah. His father Abu Quhafa radiallahu ta'ala became a Muslim at the conquest of Makkah. All his sons and daughters were Sahaba. One of his daughters, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, was the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and one of the mothers of the Ummah. One of his other daughters, Asma radiallahu ta'ala anha, was the wife of the Zubayr, who's also from the Ashra Mubashara. And his, one of his sons, Abdul Rahman, and Abdul Rahman had a son as well who was also a Sahabi. Four generations of Sahaba in one family. So Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, whatever he had, he spent in the path of Allah. Allah sent special salam, asked Abu Bakr, is he happy with me? Once Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he met one of his old friends from the days of Jahiliyyah, who used to know him. And he asked him, and then when he saw what Abu Bakr had become, spending in the path of Allah, helping to free slaves and others, and then he looked at Abu Bakr, and Abu Bakr, look at yourself, what have you become? Were you not better off when before this new religion, when you had so much wealth and you had respect and honor in society? Look at what you've become now. Abu Bakr radiallahu, he said, Allahu Akbar, he said, you've lost so much. His friend said to Abu Bakr, you've lost everything. By becoming Muslim, you've lost everything. And then Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, he said something to the effect, I haven't lost anything. The losers are those who, all the people are in a loss except those who believe. He said, all the losers are those who don't believe and don't do good deeds and don't enjoin the good and forbid the evil and don't enjoy sabr. Allah loved what Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu had said so much so, Allah turned it into Quran and revealed a surah entitled Surah Al-Asr, about which Imam Shafi rahimahullah has said, if Allah had not revealed any other part of Quran, only just this one surah, that would have been sufficient for the guidance of a man. And this surah was revealed in response to the sacrifice and answer of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Allahu Akbar. So I was saying the Quran is a book of guidance. And when we see, mashallah, when we go in the path of Allah, when we hear these things, but we hear fadail of zikr, of salat, of and stories of sahaba. Some people say there are stories which are weak narrations. They're only stories. They're not telling you to do something. And in any case, about zikr, I was saying about zikr, Ibn Kathir, Allah has said, whatever Allah has ordained, Allah has set limits, except zikr. There is no limit. Allah demands and deserves to be remembered. يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم. Whether you're standing, sitting or lying, Allah deserves that you should remember Him. And you should never forget Him. Because if you forget Allah, وَلَا تَكُونُ كَالَّذِينَ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسَهُمْ. If you forget Allah, then Allah will make you forget yourself. Those who don't remember Allah, they don't know what they are doing. They are in fact forgetting themselves. So when Allah has said so much, if there is a weak narration, then what's wrong with that? All the muhaddithun in their books have brought weak narrations as well. Imam Tirmidhi has brought weak narrations. Imam Abu Dawud, Imam Nisa'i, Imam Ibn Majah, for encouragement. And even Imam Bukhari, in some of his other books, other than Sahih Bukhari, has also presented weak narrations as well, or Da'if narrations. So if Maulana Zakriya rahmahullah has compiled weak hadiths in Fazal al-Amal to encourage people, then there is no big deal, because the ahkams, whatever he's put the hadiths to support, are not proven from Quran. Who can deny the importance of Salah? Is anybody going to deny the importance of Salah? So whatever is there is simply for encouragement, so that we all read better Salah. And if Allah, the first thing Allah is going to ask on the day of Qiyamah is about Salah, so you can just understand its importance. Inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar wasta'inu bis sabri was salah. When the Quran speaks volumes about Salah, about zikr, wadhkurullaha kathira, remember Allah excessively. So if there is a narration which is, happens to be weak, and in any case, if a hadith is da'if, it's an opinion of scholars. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't say that this hadith is sahih or da'if. Scholars, may Allah bless them, may Allah reward the muhaddithun, are seeing the chain of narration, then they pass their opinions and verdicts on particular chains and sanads. And that is, they think in their opinion, this is sahih or this is da'if. This is why all muhaddithun have brought, even accepted da'if hadiths for encouragement. And in Fazal al-Amal, those hadiths are simply for encouragement. And when it comes to Masail, the ulama of Sharif, they say, you go home, wherever you come from, in your local masjid, whatever opinion your imam follows, or whatever opinion is there, you ask him. In Tabligh, we don't discuss Masail, we don't discuss politics, we don't compare, we don't criticize, now we don't approve or disapprove, let anybody do whatever they are doing, but let them be Muslims. And bring people to the path of Allah. Allah loves this. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. In Dawah, Allah wants people to call people to Allah. and to worship Allah. Dawah is based on the tertib of Adhan. And the best form of Dawah is Adhan. Allahumma Rabba hadihi Dawah. Dawah is Tamma. Tamma means perfect. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us how to pray, how to perform Hajj, how to do Zikr. But when he came to Dawah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave Dawah as well, but did not restrict that this is only thing. And that this is, many people, mashallah, do dawah by putting up tables. We don't say bid'ah. Did the Prophet ever put up a dawah table? Did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his days, were there sky channels? Were there audio cassettes? Were there radios? So we are not saying that this is bid'ah or this is wrong. But dawah is what is based on the tarteeb of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And on the same tarteeb, it will be most effective. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, by teaching people adhan and then teaching people the dua after adhan, approved the tertib of dawah. Allahumma rabba hadhihi dawati tamma. This adhan is the best form of dawah, the perfect form. And how does adhan begin? Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. So dawah will always begin with the greatness of Allah. Talk about the greatness of Allah. Ya ayyuha al-muddathir, qum fa'andhir, wa rabbaka fakabbir. Hence in Tawheed, you then talk about the greatness of Allah. Then you will talk about obeying Allah, about worshipping Allah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. But the most, Allahu Akbar. First four times, and then at the end two times as well. So Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. So the best, the most important subject in da'wah is the greatness of Allah. So if you can learn the greatness of Allah, you can learn to begin dawah. Then ashadu an la ilaha illallah. Then we confess to the greatness of Allah. Only He ought to be worshipped. And how? Ashadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. On the tertib of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then hayya ala salah. The most important sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His most important teaching is salah. Because salah hayya ala salah hayya ala al-falah. Salah will bring you, guarantee you success. So in dawah, you should encourage people to pray. And hence in tabligh, all programs are after salah. Your fajr bayan is after fajr. Your talim is after salah, after zuhr. And usually after asr, gasht after asr. And then you go out and bring people. And the brother says, inshallah, there will soon be namaz. And after namaz, there will be talk about iman and yaqeen. You hayya ala salah, hayya ala al-falah. And inshallah, we sit there, we listen, and Allah will give us success in this world and the last hereafter. This is from the Quran. This is from the tertib of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Our iman, your salah will guarantee you success. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر. Why? Because Allah is the greatest. When you worship Allah, Allah will bring you success. Allah will bring you success. Because Allah is the greatest. لا إله إلا الله. Allah doesn't need anyone. Allah doesn't fear anyone. Allah is the greatest. So if Allah is with you, you've got nothing to worry about. So in tabligh, the tertib, the amal of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the seal of all the prophets. Allah gave him a gist of the efforts of all the prophets before him. There were some prophets, they came for a family. Allah says about Ismail alayhi salatu wa sallam, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِسْمَعِيلِ. Oh my beloved prophet, talk about Ismail in the Quran. إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَادِقَ الْوَعْدِ وَكَانَ رَسُولَ النَّبِيَّ وَكَانَ يَأْمُرُ أَهْلَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ. Because Ismail used to command his family. Because when Ibrahim left Ismail alayhi salam and Hajar alayhi salam, and then they were there, and then other people came and joined them. Ismail alayhi salam married into them. So Ismail alayhi salam was a prophet for his family. وَكَانَ يَأْمُرُ أَهْلَهُ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَالزَّكَاةِ. He was a prophet from his family. Allah commanded Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to command your family as well. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاسْتَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. Command your family as well to establish salah. And in tabligh, this is, mashallah, this is facilitated by your talim at home. So your talim at home will encourage your family, your children, your wife, mashallah, and your close relatives, your dependents, mashallah. So this is, your home talim is like the sunnah of Ismail alayhi salam and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some prophets were sent to their own nations, to their own land rather. Allah says about Yunus alayhi salam, وَإِلَى مَدْيَنَا أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا. Allah sent Allah sent Shu'ayb alayhi salatu wasalam to Madian. And Allah says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَلِتُنْذِرَ أُمَّ الْقُرَىٰ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا. I have sent you to warn the people of Mecca and the surrounding area. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was given the effort of Ismail alayhi salam, of Shu'ayb alayhi salatu wasalam, and in tabligh the same tartib is facilitated in your local guest, mashallah. When you do your local guest and you masjid taleem, that is like the amal of Shu'ayb alayhi salam. That is like the amal of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in warning the people and giving da'wah to the people in your locality. وَمَنْ حَوْلَهَا. And the people around. So you're ballooning guests and you're 3 days in the neighboring vicinities. And this is like the effort of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Mecca and going to Taif, nearby town. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was commanded by Allah, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. Oh you people, I am Rasul of Allah for all of you. So by going 4 months and 40 days, you go into other countries, you go to other parts of the world, you go to different parts of the country for 40 days and for 4 months, mashallah. So in this manner, you get the nur and you get a flavor of the da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you get an opportunity to get a share in the effort of all the prophets. I was saying, Hazrat Rahmanullah used to say, Allah has covered tabligh with simplicity. Allah has made it so effective and so powerful, but yet so simple. And it's the simplicity of tabligh which is keeping people away. Many a people, they look down upon what's tabligh. Now it's the same old bayan, the same old thing, the same old story, and the same old message, the same old methodology, the same old gush, the same old fazail. Yes, brother, Allah has made it simple so that everybody can do it. If tabligh was complicated and you needed to do a special course, and in a special college, special darul ulum, special madrasa for 6 months, or whatever, Allah Rabbul Alameen Jalla Jalaluhu, Allah Himself taught the prophets how to do da'wah. Allah trained the prophets to do da'wah. Allah inspired them Himself. Prophets did not used to have a teacher from amongst the people. Allah was their teacher. Allah was their direct teacher. So people who were taught by Allah, if we are going to do their work, how much training do you think we ought to have? So if people were required to train to do the work of da'wah, they would never be able to do so. But Allah has made it simple so that everybody can do it. And because it's simple, when you start it, it gets done. And shaitan just one, oh gosh, so and so, talim and so, bayan and so and so. But mashallah, many a time, even a new brother, when he gets up, although the elders, they say, when you go out, mashallah, and you call people, don't, you know, appoint someone just who can't even speak properly. Appoint someone who can at least deliver the message, because you call the people to listen to the bayan. So appoint someone who can speak and inshallah get a decent message across. But sometimes with mashra, when someone is decided, he mashallah on many occasions, the new brother mashallah, but because of his sacrifice, Allah puts upon his tongue words mashallah, and they come from his heart and they go direct into the heart. Allah makes it easy. Allah bless it. And because it is simple, it is safe. There's no slogans, there's no support for any other thing which is going on. One Jamaat went into one country and people put CID after them. And they came and sat with them, they listened to their bayans, and they said they stayed with them many days, and they went back and reported to their superiors. These people, you know what, I don't think we need to fear them. Because they only speak about what's on top of the heavens and what's under the earth. What's in between, we don't want to know. Everybody knows what's going on. They can see, they can hear. You don't need to tell people what's going on. But what you need to do is you need to tell people as soon as they leave this world, what's going to happen. What they're going to be asked. مَا رَبُّكَ مَا دِينُكَ مَا نَبِيُّكَ. And you're going to be asked from the knowledge Allah gave you, what did you put into practice? Where did you make your living? How did you spend it? How did you spend your youth? How did you spend your life? They need to be reminded in this manner. So this is your da'wah. No comparison about other things, or he's better or he's worse. No, your matter is with Allah. Allah knows what you are doing. Allah knows your sacrifices. Allah knows what's in your heart. So just turn to Allah. And when you make effort for the sake of Allah with sacrifice and you go, Allah will accept your du'as. The angels which carry the arsh of Allah. Allah has mentioned this in the Quran. الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ. Those angels who carry the arsh of Allah. They are specially great 8 angels. Can you imagine those angels which carry the arsh of Allah, how great they will be? يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشَ وَمَنْ حَوْلَهُ. There are other angels which are in Allah's presence. And they glorify in Him, Allah, continually. And such angels, الذين يحملون العرش ومن حوله يسبحون بحمد ربهم. Then they praise Allah. ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا. And they seek forgiveness for those who believe, for the people of Iman. ويستغفرون للذين آمنوا ربنا وسعت كل شيء رحمة وعلما. يا الله, your knowledge and your rahmat is so vast. فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك. يا الله, we ask you to forgive those who make tawbah and they go in your path. فاغفر للذين تابوا واتبعوا سبيلك وقهم عذاب الجحيم. And save them from the fire of Jahannam. ربنا وأدخلهم جنات عدن التي وعدتهم ومن صلح من آبائهم وذرياتهم. يا الله, put them into Jannah, and يا الله, put the good people from their children and their parents into Jannah as well. And they make dua for you, for your children, for your parents, so that Allah will unite you all. Because when you go in the path of Allah, you're leaving behind your family, your children, your parents, so they can see. They know what it is, subhanAllah, they can see the sacrifice that you are making. So even they put in a special word, they put in a special dua in Allah's presence for the people who go in the path of Allah. So when you go 40 days, when you go 4 months, Allahu Akbar, what awaits you? The duas of the angels. The duas of the angels. And Allah Himself has said, there's a verse in the Quran, and the 24th Juz, in which Allah says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. Whose word can be better than his who invites people to Allah? And the verse previous to this, Allah talks about those who continue striving. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. And those who put themselves in the service of Allah and declare Allah to be their Lord and they are servants of Allah, so they will do the work of Allah, not just for 40 days and for 4 months. And tabligh is not a robe that you put on when you go in Jamaat. And when you come back in London Markaz, Dewsbury Markaz, you take it off. We'll see you next year. No, you got to stand by it. You go in the path of Allah to learn to do tabligh, then you come back. And then you come back and you do tabligh in your own locality. A couple of weeks ago, I was telling you the story of the jinns. Those who came and they heard, they saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam reciting Quran when he was coming back from Taif, he started praying and he was reciting Quran. Some jinns had been sent this way. Allah directed them this way. And when they saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they saw him and they heard him praying, reciting Quran, فَلَمَّا حَضَرُوهُ قَالُوا أَنْسِتُوا. And they all listened very attentively and quietly. فَلَمَّا قُدِيَ. And when the Prophet finished his recitation, وَلَّوْا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِمْ مُنْذِرِينَ. And they went back to warn their people. In other words, they were going back like our elders. They say, when you come back from Jamaat, go to your locality, not just to pack up tabligh and to say goodbye and to say hello again next year. No, but to go back to your locality and to make Jamaat and to take part in the muqami effort. So these jinns, they were not given hidayat and waqtibat by the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They understood themselves and they made niyyah to go back to their own people and to give them dawah. And when they went back, they gathered the people, they made gasht and they gathered their, they gave them karguzari and they made nakat tashkeel. And they gave the karguzari, يَا قَوْمَنَا إِنَّا سَمِعْنَا كِتَابًا أُنزَلَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مُوسَى مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْحَقِّ وَإِلَى طَرِيقٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. We've heard a book which has been revealed after Musa alayhi salam, and this book, it guides to the truth. So what you do? يَا قَوْمَنَا أَجِيبُوا دَاعِيَ اللَّهِ. This was their tashkeel, not the tashkeel. Now believe in their da'iyah of Allah. So in the local effort. So you've got to continue tabligh. It's not just a label you put on. Allah has directed tabligh. Tabligh is not from Dewsbury or Nizamuddin or Raivind. Tabligh is from Allah. The same Allah who gives instruction for salat, for fasting, for hajj. قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدُوْ إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. Oh my beloved Prophet, tell the people, this is my path to invite people to Allah with basirat. أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. This is the work, this is my work and the work of every one of my followers. So this is the work of every Muslim to be done throughout our lives, wherever we go. ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ. And if you stand by it and you carry on throughout your life, wherever you go, mashallah, as well as praying, seeking knowledge, doing dhikr of Allah, showing respect for your Muslim brothers, caring for them, being good to them, helping them in the time of need. خَيْرُ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَنْفَعُ النَّاسِ. The best people are those who help other people. وَاللَّهُ فِي أَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ الْعَبْدُ فِي أَوْنِ يَخْصِي. As long as you're helping another Muslim, Allah showered His special mercy upon you, all to please Allah. So when you continue in this manner, and mashallah, throughout your life you did what you could in the best manner that you could, And then when your time comes to leave this world, تتنزل عليهم الملائكة. Allah sends angels, and the angels they come. Allah says, if only you could see. If only you could see. ولو ترى إذ يتوفى الملائكة طيبين يقولون سلام عليكم. If you could only see good people, the ones who live their lives as Allah wanted them to live, as Allah wanted them to live, when they leave this world and the angels come and they say, Salaam, well done, you've done really well. Udkhulul Jannah, let's take you to Jannah. Allah takhafu wa la tahzanu wa abshiru bil Jannah. Have no worry, have no fear. You're not going to a bad place. Be assured, we're not going to take you anywhere bad. We're going to take you to somewhere very special where there'll be walakum fiha ma tashtahi anfusukum walakum fiha ma tadda'un. You've done well, you've lived your life in the manner that Allah wanted you to live. Now Allah will do whatever you say. Allah will give you whatever. Allah will give you palaces. People struggle to have a council flat here, 2-bedroom, 3-bedroom house, but Allah will give you palaces. Allah will give you وَمَسَاكِنَ طَيِّبَةً فِي جَنَّاتِ عَدْلٍ. Palaces made of gold and silver. تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. Your own gardens, your own kingdoms. And Allah will say, Allah Himself will say, when people are settled in their palaces with their garden and their wives and everything, and they see all that Allah has given them, and they will be engrossed in all that Allah gave them, and all happy, and all engrossed in enjoyment, all of a sudden, a cloud will hover over them, and they will look up, and from there they will hear, As-salamu alaykum ya ibadi. Allah Himself will visit them and say, peace be upon you, O my servants. Hala rabitum, are you happy? Aturiduna shayyan azidukum. Is there anything else that you want that I may give you? And then they will say, Ya Allah, alam tubayyid wujuhana wa tudkhilan al-jannata wa tunajjina min al-nar. Ya Allah, have you not enlightened our faces? You saved us from Jahannam and put us in this wonderful place. What else could we ask, Ya Allah, of you? And he says, فَيُكْشَفُ الْحِجَابِ. Allah will raise the veils which exist between Allah and His makhluk. فَمَا عُوتُوا شَيْئًا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّظَرِ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ. There will be nothing special, even in Jannah, as special as seeing Allah Himself. Allah Himself. Allah in Jannah, there will be people who've done well, mashallah. Allah will give them palaces and say, go and live your life. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا. You know that when we have a guest, then when someone comes to our house, we say, brother, here's the key to the house. You can come and go whenever you want. This is your house, you know, treat it like your house. You can come and go wherever. And mashallah, this is your place. You can stay here and relax. But if there is someone special, then you don't just give them the key. Then what they do, they appoint a servant or someone, some child or someone to look after him. Because he's a stranger to the town. He doesn't know where to go. He doesn't know the underground system or the bus system or how to go and wherever. So you appoint someone to take him with you. But if someone extra special, then what you do? You take time off work. Then you go to the airport to receive them. Then you bring them to your house yourself personally. And as long as they stay with you, some very big sheikh or someone, you've already made arrangements to take time off and to be with them yourself. Because you don't want anything to go wrong. Not with this one. You want everything to be in place and perfect. So Allah says about some people in Jannah, they will live in Jannah as they please. Other people, وَيُسْقَوْنَ فِيهَا كَأْسًا كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا زَنْجَبِيلًا. They will have special servants, but there will be some special people. Allah says, وَسَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ شَرَابًا تَهُورًا. Allah Himself will entertain them. Allah Himself will personally oversee. Why? Because they were special servants of Allah. So to me, my dear brothers, is the special work of Allah. The work of the most special people of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. If there was anything more special than tabligh, Allah would have given it to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The first thing which the Prophet did was to give da'wah. And when he came back from the cave of Hira, before teaching people to pray, he gave them da'wah. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, before doing anything else, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala learned to give da'wah. Sahaba learned this lesson of da'wah. Allah says about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّا سَمَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا. Oh my beloved Prophet, specially I've made you as a da'i. Da'im. So da'wah is a very special amal, special blessing of Allah for this ummah. This is something we all need to do, and we all need to learn how to do it properly. And we need to do it in the manner in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has described. And the tartib of da'wah, learning to talk about Allah, learning to invite people to Allah, to the ways of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to salah, and do this effort throughout our lives, and do it throughout the world, my dear brothers. But learn to do it properly, inshallah. So for this we need to spend 4 months and go in the path of Allah for 4 months, brother. So if you give, mashallah. Who's ready? Give your names, brother, mashallah. May Allah bless you and reward you, mashallah. What's your name, brother?